गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सी टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट शेड्यूल, दैट इज शेड्यूल नंबर 8. ओके, सो इन दिस शेड्यूल नंबर 8 टू लेसन्स आर देयर, बट दैट केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड टाइप्स ऑफ रिएक्शंस, दैट लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू कैंसिल इट, बिकॉज ऑन द बेस ऑफ दैट रिएक्शन फॉर 6th स्टैंडर्ड दे आर नॉट आस्किंग एनी क्वेश्चंस इन द अवर होमियो अवर फर्स्ट लेवल एग्जाम. Okay, so carbon and its compound, some basic information we are going to learn in this schedule. So before to start this lesson, now we will see what is a carbon. See, carbon, now in the element compound and mixture, in that you have learned that carbon, okay, it is one element. So this you know that carbon is one element. So why means what are the compounds of carbon? See, so that some uses of carbon compounds that we are going to learn. See, actually this carbon and its compounds, this in a detail you are going to learn in class 10. Okay, because one specially one chapter it is given totally that is based on carbon and its compound. But now for your class, see, the some basic information about carbon and its compound we are going to learn. Okay, as you know that the carbon is denoted by symbol C. Okay, means this is the basic knowledge you have that carbon is denoted by symbol C. Now this carbon is a basic unit of our life. Means as you know that the oxygen is very essential for our life, okay, and hydrogen, because oxygen hydrogen is combined from water, so these two elements are very important in our life. So that way the third most important element, that is a carbon, because the so many things surrounded by us, that all the things contain carbon. Now see, here I have a chalk, okay, this chalk is also made up of carbon, it contains a carbon, so this calcium carbonate, the formula we will learn afterwards. Okay, so this chalk is contain carbon. See, whatever the things when you will burn in the paper, for example, see here, this is a paper, okay, when you will burn this paper, then what, you will get the ash, and that ash it is in a black in color. So when the things you will burn, and after that in the form of residue, if you will get the black substance, means what, that particular substance contain carbon. Okay, so when you will get the ash of this paper, so mean that is a black in color, so means what, it contain a carbon. So carbon is present in most of the things. Wood, in wood also it contain a carbon. Okay, so the carbon is very important in our regular life. Now see, I have written some important points related to the carbon. What is, see, carbon is the basis of life. Now why it is a basis of life, because most of the things contain a carbon. Okay, so many things we are using regularly, this furnitures, this blackboard, this chalk, then wooden furniture, so many things we wear, clothes. Okay, so these all the things contain carbon, and because of that the carbon is the basis of life. Now see, matter constitute all living things contain carbon. Now you know that all the things, means everything is a matter. What is the definition of matter? Matter means what? It has a mass and occupies space. Okay, it is known as a matter. So all the things matter, and most of the things it contain a carbon. Okay, and some living things also. Okay, so in some living things also it contain a carbon. Now see the next, it is one of the most widely spread element on the earth. Now it is, why it is known as a widely spread element on the earth, because so many things contain carbon, so it is known, it is a widely spread element on the earth. And see, it is the third most important. See, just now I told you it third most important element. Now oxygen is very essential element for us, because without oxygen we can't breathe. For breathing purpose oxygen very necessary. Okay, so oxygen is very important in our life. After that hydrogen, and then the third most important element, that is a carbon. Okay, so this is some basic introduction about carbon, means why carbon is important, what is the importance of carbon in our day-to-day life. Now we will see in a short way, that is what is the structure of carbon. Okay, these all the points you just write down in your notebook. Now we will learn about structure of carbon. Okay, see, as you learn in element compound and mixture, that is atomic number of elements. Okay, so you have learned about the atomic numbers of elements. So now you just tell me what is the atomic number of carbon. Atomic number, see, atomic number of carbon is 6. Okay, then symbol is C. C means what? Carbon. Then C, mass number is 12, and valency is 4. C means at least these information you should know about the carbon, that is atomic number of carbon is 6, then symbol of carbon is C, mass number of carbon is 12, and valency is 4. Now I'll show you a structure of carbon. See, this is a nucleus. Okay, and these are the orbits which it is means in atomic structure these are the orbits. Okay, so in the nucleus what? Protons and neutrons are present. So proton 6 and neutron 6, right? Because atomic number of carbon is 6. So how many electrons? See, protons and neutrons and electrons. See, I am writing here protons, neutrons and electrons are subatomic particles. Now you know that carbon is one atom. Okay, so these are the subatomic particles of atom. So in atom these subatomic particles are present. Okay, so carbon is one atom. So all elements, if you will take that, this now we are specially we are discussing about carbon. So carbon is one atom, and in these atom the subatomic particles are present, that is protons, neutrons and electrons. So protons, it is denoted by P and having a positive charge. Okay, neutrons, no charge, it is denoted by N. Okay, neutrons, no charge, not positive and negative, and electrons having a, it is denoted by E and having a negative charge. So what is proton, neutrons and electrons are subatomic particles of carbon. Okay, do you understand it? Now where is the place of these subatomic particles in this atomic structure? See, protons and neutrons are present in the nucleus. So this middle one is a nucleus, and outside some orbitals or shells are there. In higher classes you will learn about that, which these cells. Okay, so these electrons are revolve around this shell. So in the first shell 2 electrons are present, in second shell 4 electrons. Okay, now see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons, because number, atomic number is equal to number of protons and number of neutrons. Okay, so number of electrons also 6. And now here I have written, that is mass number is 12. number is 12 because the mass number formula is number of protons plus number of neutrons. So number of protons 6, number of neutrons 6. So 6 plus 6, how many? 12. So mass number of carbon is 12. How? You got it? Okay. So, and these electrons are revolve around the orbit. I am just giving introduction about the atomic structure of carbon. In detail you will learn in a higher classes. But you should know about what are the subparticles of atoms. So, protons, neutrons and electrons. Okay. So, do you understand the structure of carbon? See, it's very important. Atomic number 6, symbol is C. Mass number 12, why? Because number of protons 6 and number of neutrons 6, so both, if you will do addition, you will get the 10. So mass number formula is number of protons plus number of neutrons, and valency is a 4. Now valency means in the outermost shell, whatever the electrons are present, this shell is known as the valence shell. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 electrons, so 4 is a valency of this carbon. Okay, so now in the next period we will learn about next topic. Thank you.